Hi guys. Welcome back to the Fact TV channel. This time we will discuss about HSE management system. What is HSE management system? HSE management system is a comprehensive framework used by organizations in preventing, mitigating, and eliminating disruptions and losses caused by workplace accidents, risk and hazard exposures, and environmental phenomena. There are 8 elements that should be done. 1. Leadership, commitments and accountability. 2. Policy and strategic objectives. 3. Organization resources and competence. 4. Risk evaluation and management. 5. Planning standards and procedures. 6. Implementations and monitoring. 7. HSE audit. 8. Management review. So the outline for this element is HSE management system is key to monitoring an organization's compliance with relevant laws, regulations and standards. So the purpose of HSE management system is control or eliminate potential hazards to achieve an acceptable risk level in accordance with established standards. Prevent work accidents and work-related diseases by involving elements of management and workers or laborers. Creating a safe, comfortable, and efficient workplace to boost productivity. Improving the effectiveness of occupational safety and health protection, planned, measurable, structured, and integrated. In the following, we will explain and break down in detail the 8 elements of the HSE management system. But before we continue this video, please subscribe, turn on notifications, and like this video. Let's we continue. Number 1. Leadership. Commitments and accountability. Leadership visibility. Participation in HSE walkthroughs, investigations, and campaigns. HSE meeting. Taking feedback from the workforce. Reviewing stop of work, SOW. Spending time with the workers in the field and demonstrate duty of care. This is the best way to build trust. Provide on-spot decisions for critical HSE and welfare issues. Share lessons learned of any serious incidents that occur at other sites. Proactive target, KPI setting. For example, 100% induction and job-specific training. 100% compliance with PPEs. 100% reporting unsafe actions, unsafe conditions, near misses, life-saving rule violations. 100% implementation of the HSE assurance program. Maintain HSE passport at the site. Awareness and campaign on associated hazards. Near misses reporting. And LSRs. Recognize the good performers and apply consequence management for violators. Number 2. Policy and strategic objectives. HSE policy is one of the primary documents all organizations should have in place. It sets out the health, safety, and environment objectives, responsibilities, and arrangement. Having a good HSE policy delivers many benefits, including clear communication from HSE management. It is also a legal requirement by many HSE acts and regulations. There are 3 main parts or sections of the HSE policy. A. Statement of intent. B. Organization section. C. Arrangement section. Number 3. Organization resources and competence. A structured organization that clearly defines roles and responsibilities and accountability. Org chart with reporting line linked to corporate HSE also in line with the scope of work. Provide adequate resources, human and fund. And the right person for the right job. Selection process. Previous track record. Competency of people. Safety awareness. HSE training matrix in line with the scope of work. Mandatory and job specific. Number 4. Risk evaluation and management. The HSE management system element addressed identification, evaluation, and management of HSE hazard and evaluation of HSE risks for all activities, product and services, and the development of measures to reduce these risks. Hazard identification and taking control measures. There are two types of risk assessments. Number one, qualitative. Number two, quantitative. On the right side of this word, you can see the risk matrix. Number five, planning standards and procedures. Before performing the activity, we have to plan the activity. Then accordingly, we will set the standard and will be performed the activity according to the approved procedure. For example, plan for communication through HSE meetings, awareness, campaigns, on-site training, HSE equipment, such as fire extinguisher, fire hydrant, and fire detector system. All such equipment needs to be inspected so that it is available in functional condition during an emergency. Emergency response plan, waste management plan, works on 3R, reduce, reuse, recycle, welfare management plan, accommodation, food or water, health and safety, transportation, recreation, payment or leaves, equipment maintenance, preventive and periodic maintenance schedule with the tracking mechanism, short service employee, SSE, managing risk associated with newcomers in the site activity through audit and review. Number 6. Implementations and monitoring. This HSE management system element addresses the manner in which activities are to be performed and monitored, and corrective action to be taken when necessary. Implementation, site inspections, HSE training plans, non-compliance and corrective action, performance monitoring and records, incident reporting and follow-up. Number 7. HSE audit. It is a planned, systematic, and critical evaluation of the HSE management system by a competent person. It will identify weaknesses and suggest changes in the HSE management system implementation process or in a setting of inadequate or unrealistic targets. After auditing, the result of the audit will guide on what to do next if the outcomes show a lapse in the HSE management system. There are two types of HSE audits. Internal HSE audit. External HSE audit. 1. Internal HSE audit. That is normally performed by the internal team to evaluate the current status and effectiveness of the management system. 2. External HSE audit. It is the second type of audit, which is usually conducted by third-party certifying bodies and insurance companies. Number 8. Management review. Every HSE management system needs to be reviewed to verify that current goals are being met and new initiatives are being put in place. A review of the management system and team by senior leadership should be conducted on a regular basis. This keeps staff and the system accountable and presents the opportunity for discussion between safety personnel and upper management. That's it. The HSE management system with 8 elements that must be carried out in order to create a safe, comfortable and healthy work environment. Thank you.
Don't forget to subscribe, like, and turn on notifications. Thank you.